first order of A is equal to 4. If order of A is equal to 4, then these elements are distinct. E, A, A square, these are four elements are distinct. And we have A raised to 4 equal to E. That means in this case, our group I can write down as G1, it is equal to E, A, A square, A cube, and A raised to 4 equal to E. Second case, let us take. This is case 1. This is now, this is we take case alpha, and now we take case beta. We assume that each element, there is no element with order 4. That means each element A different from E has order 2. Let us take two distinct elements A and B, both belonging to G. Then order of A equal to order of B equal to 2. This implies A square equal to B square equal to E, and this implies A is equal to A inverse and B is equal to B inverse. Now let us take this third element AB. Then AB can't be AB. If AB is equal to E, then we get A equal to B inverse. B inverse is equal to B, and that means we get A equal to B. This implies A equal to B inverse equal to B, that means we get A equal to B, contradiction to that part that A is not equal to B. If you assume that AB equal to B, then this implies A equal to E. And similarly, AB equal to A implies B equal to E. That means we have four elements E, A, B, and AB. That means I can write down the group G, G2, that is another group with four elements E, A, B, AB. And here we get A square equal to B square equal to E. Now, again AB is not equal to E. So order of AB is 2, and that implies that AB must be equal to its inverse, AB inverse, that is equal to B inverse, A inverse, and that is equal to AB. That means what we get here is AB, and the relation is equal to this. So what we prove here is that if G is any group of order 4, then structure is either identical with the group G1 or with the group G2. Alright, now we take the case, second case, and order of the group G is 6. Here we take any element A different from E, then order of A divides 6, and that implies order of A equal to 2, 3, and 6. The first case, order of A equal to 6, I am writing immediately because all of you will understand that part, that here our group G1 becomes E, A, A square, A cube, A raised to 4, A raised to 5, and A raised to 6 is equal to E. So now we consider this case, order of A is equal to 2 or 3. Suppose we assume, each element A different from E has order 2. Then we take two elements A and B, both belonging to G. And just now what we show here is, all right, if I take H is equal to E, A, B, A, B with A square equal to B square equal to E, A, B is equal to B, A, then this becomes a subgroup of G. And number of elements here is 4. So by Lagrange's theorem, order of H divides order of G, that is 4 divides 6, we get a contradiction. And so our assumption that each element A different from E has order 2 is not true. There is at least one element B different from E which has order 3. So element B has different order 3 implies these three elements are distinct. E, B, B square and B cube is equal to E. Now we take one element A which does not belong to the cyclic group, subgroup generated by B. That is, what is this? E, B and B square. And what we can prove here is, or I will leave it to all of the students, that here we can prove that G comes out equal to E, B, B square, A, A, B and A, B square. These are all distinct six elements of the group G, and since G has only six elements, what we can prove is this. Or moreover, also we can prove that A square equal to E and BA is equal to AB square. So we can say very easily here that AB is not equal to BA, and so this is a group of order 6. All that this is, if I call this a G2, then it is a non-commutative group. We can see on the screen, all of this is the table for this group. Yes, that is, all of this is, we can see here, that is a table for the group. Instead of this, I have taken, okay, BA and B square A, and that we get here is this. Okay. All right. So, what we prove is that if you have a group of order 6, then up to isomorphism, there are only two distinct groups. One is the cyclic subgroup generated by A element of order 6, and second is G2 is equal to E, B, B square, A, B, A, B square, A, where A square equal to E and B A is equal to A, B square. Thus, with the help of Lagrange's theorem, we have a classification of groups of order 4 and 6. We prove the Lagrange's theorem. So immediately one question came to our mind. Is converse of Lagrange's theorem is true? In other words, suppose G is a finite group. That means OG is a finite integer. And suppose N is an integer, positive integer. Such that M divides OG. Then converse part say that can G have a subgroup of order M? Alright, the answer to this question is no in general. Alright, this is, and to prove, to show this, alright, we have to take the help of our permutation group S4, alright, with S is equal to 1, 2, 3, and 4. And here we take its subgroup A4. First of all, let us see what are the number of elements in S4. The number of elements in S4 is equal to factorial 4, and that is equal to 24. We take its subgroup, alternative subgroup, the set of all even permutations in S4, and if we want, we can write down the elements E 1 2 3 4 1 3 2 4 1 4 2 3, M is equal to 1 2 3, M square is equal to 1 3 2, L is equal to 1 2 4, L square is equal to 1 4 2, P is equal to 1 3 4, P square is equal to 1 4 3, Q is equal to 2 3 4, and Q square is equal to 2 4 3. This. So we have, alright, A4. and number of elements in A4 is 12. And let us take now M equal to 6. That means M divides the order of the group A4. But we will show that this A4, this group A4 has no subgroup of order 6. And the proof is by contradiction. Suppose H is a subgroup of G, subgroup of A4 with order of H is equal to 6. Now our group A4 is finite, and so by Lagrange's theorem, index of A4 H in A4 is equal to order of A4 upon order of H, and that comes out 12 upon 6, and that gives you 2. That, in other words, the subgroup H has two distinct right cosets in A4. Now let me take this element M. First let me tell you one thing more. E is an identity element, so its order is 1. If you take these three elements, each has order 2. All remaining elements, 8 elements, has order 3, because they are cycles of order 3, 3 cycles, and so their order is equal to 3. Now let me take one cycle M, and let us consider the coset H, HM and HM square. Just I told you that H has only two distinct right cosets in A4. So out of these three, two must be equal. That means we have this possibility. The first possibility, that HM is equal to H. Second possibility, HM square is equal to H. And third possibility, that HM square is equal to HM. And now here we use one important property of a coset, and that I state here as a theorem. Suppose H is a subgroup of G, and A and B are two elements belonging to G. Then the first property is that H is equal to the right coset HA if and only if A belongs to H. And second is that two right coset HA and HB, they are equal if and only if AB inverse belongs to H. They are very simple to prove, and so we can prove it easily. Now let us come to here. HM is equal to H, and that implies that we must have, by using this, what we can have is M belongs to H. HM square is equal to H, that implies M square belongs to H. Since H is a subgroup, this implies M raised to square equal to M raised to 4, that is equal to M, belongs to H, because order of M is 3, so M raised to cube is equal to identity element. So this HM square is equal to HM, again we use this result, and so this implies M square M raised to minus 1 equal to M belongs to H. So in all the three possibilities, what we are able to show is that if M is, alright, any three cycle, then this M belongs to H. We can prove for the remaining, alright, all three cycles, and we have 8 such cycles. That means this H contains minimum 8 elements, but order of the group H is 6, and that we get a contradiction. So our supposition that H has a subgroup of orders 6 is false. Now converse is not true, right? So in mathematics we raise one more question: under what condition the converse is true? Here we can put the conditions, all right, in two ways. One condition on the group G, that is converse of Lagrange's theorem is true if we take the specials
finite group, or we can put some condition on the divisor M that is converse true if we take the special divisor M of the order of the group G. And it is very interesting to know that, all right, in both the cases the answer we get is affirmative. If we take the special group, we get this theorem. Suppose G is a finite, that is I am taking as a, all right, cyclic group. G is a finite cyclic group of order N. It is same thing as order of A. If M is any divisor, positive integer is a divisor of N, then theorem says that G has a unique subgroup, cyclic subgroup of order M. So this subgroup, all right, it is generated by the elements A raised to N upon M, and it has an order M. So here what we can say is that here that there is a 1-1 correspondence between the divisors of integer N and the subgroups of our cyclic group G. So this is the one result. Second result is very interesting, and this is known as Cauchy's theorem. Here we put the condition on group G. Now we put the condition on the divisor. That means suppose G is a finite group. If P is a prime and P divides OG, then theorem says that